made it. I almost thought you weren't gonna make it. I know it seems like nobody's here, and you're probably at home watching this right now, but we wanted to do church this way this morning, just for you, so you still can learn a Bible lesson. Let's go get you checked in. Miss Rachel and Brother Josiah are your teachers today, and they're actually gonna do a great job at teaching you the Bible story and singing the songs with you. You ready to go? Come on. Me today, Miss Rachel.
Oh, okay. Well, are you gonna get them signed in?
Right, I'm printing out their tag right now. Let me get this one here, and we're gonna get you guys in. Here you go.
Let's take you to your classroom. Follow me. Come on, let's go. Wait, slow down. Thank you for waiting for me. Thank you so much. All right, it's just around this way. Look who it is!
Hey, you made it! Awesome, how was your week today? Actually, you know what, that was really cool. Let's get you into this blue carpet right here and we'll sit you down. I'm so glad you're here today. This is awesome. Now, follow me while we're gonna do our fast worship song.
It's not a secret, it's not a fairy tale, it's not made up. Jonah was in a whale. 3 whole days, 1, 2, 3. The greatest treasure the world God's people wrote.
And listen to our story.
Long ago, when the people of the Bible lived, there was a boy named David.
David had a very important job to do. He took care of the family sheep. David would take the sheep where there was cool water to drink, green grass to eat, and shade to lie down to sleep. David played his harp and sang while he took care of the sheep. One day, while David watched the sheep, a lion crept up and grabbed a sheep in its mouth. Immediately, David began to run after the lion. David had no gun to shoot the lion. He had only a slingshot and some stones. But David knew that God would help him save his sheep. David ran after the lion and grabbed the lamb from its mouth. The lion turned on David, and he caught it by its beard and killed it. Then he took up the little lamb. He checked the lamb all over to make sure it was not hurt and put it back with the others. Another time, a bear stole a sheep from David's flock, and once again, David went after the wild animal and saved the sheep. David knew that both times God had given him the strength and courage to go after the lion and bear. David did not brag of how brave and strong he was, but instead, he told how wonderful God was to take care of him. Do you know that we have the same wonderful God that David has? And he takes care of both you and me. David's job as a shepherd boy may not have seemed very important to a lot of people, but David did the very best job he could. God is always pleased when we do our very best, no matter how big or small our job may be. God also knew that David loved him with all his heart. David wanted to please God more than anything else.
Hello, kids. It's me, Leo the Lion, and I love the Bible. And today's Bible story inspired me. I want to be like King David and attack a bear and a lion. So, they're hiding from me. Let's go find them.
I think they went in here. Let's open the door.
Hello? Mr. Bear? Mr. Lion, are you guys hiding from me? Well, good, because when I find you, I'm going to act out a Bible story. Looks like they're not here. I need to go to the other room. Barry, Coral, where are you guys? There you are. Get over here. I got you, Carl. Come with me, Carl. Come on, Carl.
I think Barry the Bear is under here. There you are, Barry. I got you, Barry. Come.
Yep, you both thought you could run. You can run, but you can't hide from Leo the Lion.
Leo?
Oh, hello, Sister Leah. And look at all the wonderful kids watching on TV. How are you?
I'm good. What are you doing?
Well, I love the Bible, and I love today's Bible story, and I wanted to be David and protect Sheepy from the bear and the lion. Don't worry. Pipe down, you guys. Don't worry. I said pipe down. We're just pretending. I'm going to go after. Is it question time?
Yeah, it is. So, So you did watch the Bible story.
All of us watched the Bible story together.
Great. Mm-hmm. That's amazing. Okay. Question time. Three questions. Are you ready?
Yes, and I know these questions. Go.
What animals did David take care of?
David took care of the sheep. Isn't that right, Sheepy?
Yeah.
See?
Okay. Good job. Question number two. What two animals came to hurt the sheep?
It's obvious. A bear and a lion, and I got both of them. Am I right? That's you guys. I caught you. Question number three.
Last question.
Yes.
Who helped David go after the lion and the bear?
Was it the Lord?
It was.
Yeah, it wasn't Leo the Lion, but that's okay. It was the Lord.
It was God.
Because just like the Lord helped David, the Lord helped Leo the Lion catch Barry and Carl. Okay, I'll let you guys go. We'll see you later.
Hey, Leo, I have a question.
Yes?
Aren't you a lion too?
Egads, you're right. I didn't think about that. I better let you guys go. We'll see you later, Sister Lee. I gotta let these guys go.
Bye, Leo.
I'm letting you guys go.
My goodness, Leo! 5 teams left on the Amazing Race!
Hey, Sheepy, can we pause it real quick so we can go over the memory verse this week?
Oh, really fast, because I want to see the Amazing Race!
Okay, okay.
Okay.
Here's your card.
Oh, how am I supposed to hold it? Okay, maybe you hold it.
Okay, I'll hold it.
What is this? Oh, I see what it says. That's a good one. Do you want me to say it?
Yes, please.
It says, "Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against you." Right?
Yeah, found in Psalms 119:11.
119:11 in the book of Psalms. "Thy
right.
word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against you." Can I watch the Amazing Race now?
Yes.
Follow me while we're going to do our fast worship song. Sunday. Can't wait to see you next week. Have fun.